Hello, good morning, how you doing? Waking up, shaking yesterday's
blues. Welcome back to our exceptional cruise through the Mediterranean. On board our ultra-luxury six-star Discovery yacht. Scenic Eclipse carries a maximum of just 228 guests, so this really is an intimate experience. Plus, her unique design gives her the distinct advantage of delivering you front and centre into the heart of the best ports along this coastline.
Another day, another country. But this isn't just any country. It's the world's second smallest. But what Monaco lacks in size, it certainly makes up in attitude. This is the billionaire's playground.
Monaco has certainly captured the world's attention thanks to its envious tax haven status. An exclusive club where one in three of its 40,000 residents are millionaires. Monaco's old town sits high above the crammed modern skyscrapers. It's also where you'll find the Royal Palace, home to His Serene Highness Prince Albert II and family.
You might recognise this church, the St Nicholas Cathedral, as it's where Grace Kelly married her Prince Rainier in 1956, a Hollywood fairy tale that captivated the world and still intrigues people, myself included.
Sadly, it's also the final resting place of America's most glamorous princess and her beloved Prince Rainier. The quaint hilltop village of St Paul de Vence, it's about an hour's drive from Monaco, luring A-listers and artists with its natural beauty.
And it continues to make history because there's always lots of famous people coming.
Oh, we've got Brad Pitt, Angelina Jolie, and so many one who are coming during the film festival. They stop in here because it's a countryside. You keep quiet here and you can relax and enjoy life.
You can be a rock star, but with a low profile.
Exactly.
Why the artists found this so inspiring.
This is called Azure, really the art of the village and the fountain. It's a lovely place where we all met, the artists, the poets, the actors, the actress. At the 19th century, we were so happy to have a fountain in the village. That's a heart for us.
Our remarkable day closes with a classical concert in the stunning Oceanographic Museum. Tonight's exclusive Scenic and Rich experience offers guests an intimate performance by the Harp City Orchestra. The Oceanographic Museum was built in 1910 by Prince Albert I to help educate and preserve his precious oceans. Our rock star treatment continues back on board. Every cruise has fabulous food and alcoholic drinks all included. The only tough decision you will have to make is where to eat.
We have 8 official restaurants on board. We consider it as 10 dining venues because of the reason of the culinary school we have on top of it and the room service. So in total, you can say you can eat, dine and have culinary experience in 10 different venues.
And tonight, head chef Tom has offered to dine with me at Coco's for some delicious Asian fusion.
I always say it's like a kid in a Toys R Us, to be honest. Whenever you feel like I want to cook Asian, I go to my Asian team. When I feel like I want to work on the French restaurants, I go to the French, so I love it. We really, really like it.
Well, we really, really like it too, so thank you.
It's my pleasure, thank you.